Hi guys, next part for the teardown of the laser Rauchwinder. Today we will open this front part containing the optics and we will have a look at the optics. So here we have Allen screws. By the way, it is quite rare to find Allen screws on aircraft equipment. In particular, vintage 60s, 70s vintage aircraft equipment. Most of the time, they are flat-head, slotted screw. But here we have Allen, and it is very convenient to have ball-ended Allen keys for this, because in the screws back here, you need to attack them at an angle. I need to order some Allen screws for replacing bad ones here. Okay. We have some very special washers on the screws here. There are three parts watertight washers. Very small. It will be difficult to show you, but we have outer ring, inner ring, and a seal. Rubber seal between both rings, probably very expensive solution, and they are quite pain because they are coming apart when you remove the screw. Okay, one more here. Okay, same washer. Now I need to pull this out. Here is a seal. Oh, it was not difficult. Okay, here is the inside. As you can see, machined aluminium here. Very nice. And here is what we have, guys. So, as you can see, very complicated and fancy optics. We have this main drum containing two sets of lens, and as you can see, servo controls here. Moving both parts inside. So if I move the camera like so for you, as you can see, here we are moving the front part. And we are changing an internal angle. In fact, the lens act like some kind of prism. And when you move them, you change the focusing, the aiming angle probably. So we have two times the same thing, one at the front and one at the rear. Here you can see this part is bolted, probably. They are bolted one to another one, the other one, like so, with bolts, but it will not be necessary to remove it, I guess. Here you can see the mechanism, very nice servo control. We have one small synchro motor, it seems. One feedback potentiometer here, and very nice gears. It is connected here with this plug, and it arrives here at the pass-through for the wires. The other one is exactly the same. So here is a little zoom in for you. You can see the very nice work here, by the way. Look at the thickness of this part here. Quite incredible. So I wonder if I could maybe separate these two parts in order to see what we have between the two parts. So let me have a look. Okay, this will be totally an experiment. I did never remove this before. So the plug on the grounding wire were quite easy to remove. And now let's see about these bolts, what we have. Yes, they are fairly long bolts, so maybe both parts will come off at the same time. But in fact, I am only interested at removing the front one, because I know the rear one, we will be able to see the rear side when disconnecting the two body parts. It is 7mm bolts here. Okay, last one, I hope everything will not drop, but yes, everything will drop. So I need to disconnect the second plug here. As you can see, here we are. So both parts could separate because I think they are two times the same thing. But in fact, if they do not want to separate, I will not try further. It seems it is just a locking pin, positioning pin. Yes. So nothing to. In fact, there are positioning pins, and you need to separate them in a very parallel way. Is not easy. And the thorium lance is throwing radiations at me, so okay, well, let me try to remove it. I was able to separate both sides, and you can see in fact the angled lance here inside, like so, and the other one like so. So each lens has its serial number, each piece, and they match one to the other one. There are small markings. I do not remember if I did them myself or these are factory. Let's check for thorium on these lenses. No, nothing. Nothing. The thorium is back here. Okay, nice. So in fact, there are two times the same unit match one to another. As you can see, really nice. So here at the back, so we have the main output. I guess the small, we have a prism in the middle, which you can see, some kind of prism here. I guess it is the laser output. And we have the main receiving lens for the receiver. This, the thorium lens, is this one. And you can see the wiring, how it is arranged, going to the pass through. So very nice and very expensive optics here, by the way. Not something you see every day. Everything is mounted on ball bearings, of course. On very thick aluminium parts. All the way around. The feedback potentiometers are serial numbered, of course. Because spare no expense. Okay, so in the next, so here is a view, one more view of the two parts for you. So next step will be to separate these two parts, just because it will be easier to deal with this without the EV lens unit. But for now, I will reassemble the lenses, so will it be easy or difficult? These two parts go like so. In fact, they are quite difficult to connect mechanically because you have to align them very precisely. So I will do it off camera because it will be tricky. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.